Well, one of the world's sexiest men did a good job of avoiding the public eye on his first trip to Sydney. Here to talk about his humanitarian work with the people of Sudan, George Clooney stayed on topic and kept away from screaming fans.
If there's one guarantee about a George Clooney appearance, it's female fans. They flocked from interstate.
We're actually from Melbourne. We made a girls' weekend of it.
Flown down.
So we are on Clooney Watch. And we're just hoping for a glimpse. That's all we want, just to see him with our own eyes.
Even from overseas.
I applied to be on a programme in England and said, what would your dream be? And it would be his housemaid.
For waiting paparazzi, George Clooney is proving a pain.
Well, that's George, isn't he? He likes his privacy.
There are big bucks to be made from the perfect picture.
George and Leo's a good picture to sell around the world. George and a lady is an even better picture.
Maggie B went weak at the knees during a meet and greet with the movie star.
He said, well, I can't even remember what he said. That's not what I'll tell my husband, though.
Pauline Hanson was playing it cool.
I think he's a good-looking guy, but again, I'm not one of these women that drool over him. So I've got a lovely man in my life, so I'm quite happy.
But finally, some pictures of the man who tried to evade Sydney's media all day. The superstar was spotted returning to his hotel after wrapping up his presentation at the Global Leadership Forum. He even stopped to have a chat and a joke with fans. But this diehard fan who camped outside of his Sydney hotel late last night wasn't so lucky.
I was hoping to see George Clooney. Yeah.
Have you got a glimpse of him yet?
Not at all. We've been waiting for like nearly an hour, but haven't seen him yet.
By George, he got away. Antoinette Latouf, 10 News.
And in the past hour, George has said his farewells to the harbour city, looking relaxed and carrying a small rucksack. He was escorted through Sydney Airport and into a special VIP area. It marks the end of his 3-day visit down under.